કરવા જઈ રહ્યા છીએ એનો પરિચય છે જ, ઓલ ઓફ અસ નો અબાઉટ ઇટ. પણ આ વર્ષે નિર્જા ફિલ્મથી આપણને થોડું વધારે નજીકથી, વધારે ઊંડાણમાં જોવા મળી છે આ વાત. પેનએમ ફ્લાઇટ 73 જેનો અમદાવાદ સાથે પણ ઘણો બધો સંબંધ છે, આપણામાંથી મોટાભાગના લોકોએ નિર્જા જોઈ છે. બટ દેર આર લોટ ઓફ સ્ટોરીઝ વિચ આર નોટ પ્રોબેબલી ફુલ્લી એક્સપ્લોર્ડ ઇન ધ ફિલ્મ. એન્ડ સમ ઓફ અસ પ્રોબેબલી ડોન્ટ નો દેટ દેર વેર લોટ ઓફ પીપલ ફ્રોમ અહેમદાબાદ ઓન ધીસ ફ્લાઇટ. એમાંથી બે સર્વાઈવર્સ સાથે આજે આપણે વાત કરવાના છીએ અને દે આર ગોઈંગ ટુ બ્રિંગ ધોઝ સ્ટોરીઝ વિચ વી પ્રોબેબલી નો વેરી લિટલ અબાઉટ. ટુ ઇન્વાઇટ અવર પેનલિસ્ટ, આઈ વુડ વોન્ટ ટુ ફર્સ્ટ કોલ અપોન જુમાના શાહ, અ જર્નલિસ્ટ એન્ડ એક્ઝિક્યુટિવ એડિટર ઓફ DNA એન્ડ ઓલ્સો વન ઓફ અર ટીમ મેમ્બર્સ એટ ગુજરાત લિટરેચર ફેસ્ટિવલ. પ્લીઝ વેલકમ હર વિથ અ બિગ રાઉન્ડ ઓફ અપ્લોઝ. થેન્ક યુ.
Thank you, Aarti. Very good evening, everyone. So as Aarti said, this session is about the PanAM-73 survivors, two of them, Janki Vasant and Khanjan Dalal. Khanjan, please come. I'll briefly introduce both of you and then give you a brief idea, one, why we are doing this session at the a literature festival at GLF, and second, the purpose of such a session. Janki Ben and Khanjan, both of them were on the plane that was hijacked on 5th of September 1986. It's about exactly 30 years now. Janki Ben is now a social worker. She has founded NGO Samvedna in 2003, which focuses on education, nutrition, and skill training. They work in the villages of Ahmedabad and around Ahmedabad, and they have reached out to lakhs of students, if I'm not mistaken, Janki Ben. I can say that, yes. Khanjan. Khanjan is an artist, and that's visual artist, and that's all that he wants me to tell you about him. The rest he will do. About that. First of all, I'd like to say why we are having this session at a literature festival. At the outset, neither Khanjan nor Janki Ben have written a book. So in the technical format of a literature festival, they would not fit into our category of authors. But there is this concept called oral literature and oral storytelling. All of us have heard stories when we were young kids from our parents or grandparents. And what we hear are the most striking memories or the most striking stories that stay with us forever. Probably, for instance, the tortoise and the hare story, or even the crow story, who throws the pebbles in the pond or the jar and brings the water up. I would want to know how many people have actually read that story, but rather heard it. And it still leaves the impressions in our minds. So that is the power of the word that you hear and the emotions that you see when your parents tell you that story. And that is what brings us to the story of Janki Ben and Khanjan. Khanjan was what, 10 years old, I believe? Or younger? 11. Khanjan was 11 and Janki Ben was just 19, yes. And they were on the flight on the ill-fated 5th of September 1986. It was going from Bombay to New York, and it stopped over in Karachi. That was their first stopover. The next one was to be in Frankfurt. At the Karachi airport, the plane was hijacked by Abu Nidal organization's four terrorists. They were fighting for the Palestinian cause. And at that time, I'm sure neither of you knew much about it or had any clue what was going on in that part of the world. If it was not for the film Neerja, I would like to believe that a lot of us would not have known about it. What is that? There is a world out there. Except for after the 9/11 attack, all of us started realizing that the word terrorist means something. That there is a word called militancy. There's a word called Muslim terrorists. You know, there are problems that these people have. And there's something that we have to bear for it. These are the people who learned about it in a very sad way. And this is their story. Two stories that they have had in the last 30 years. It's not about the Neerja story. Neerja story ended there. And we're not talking about that. We're talking about what happened to people who did not die, but they had a life, a cursed life to live with. We'll first have Janki Ben tell her story, and then Khanjan. Over to you, Janki Ben.
Namaskar. Thank you, Jumana. Thank you, GLF, for giving us this opportunity. So at this, with the perspective of Gujarat Literature Festival, if we ask ourselves a question, what is life? Then maybe we may say that life is a series of chapters, like life is a book with series of chapters, small little stories, which compiled overall and would make a story of life, a book of life. So today I'm about to share three things, two stories and one chapter that goes beyond the stories from my personal book of life, which is still in the making. To start with the first story, I assume કે ઘણા બધા અહીંયા જે હાજર છે એ લોકોએ નીરજા ફિલ્મ જોઈ હશે, કદાચ ફિલ્મ નહીં જોઈ હોય તો એ વખતે છાપાઓમાં પણ ઘણું આવતું હશે, મેગેઝિન્સનું વાંચ્યું હશે. એટલે ક્યાંક નીરજા ફિલ્મ જ્યાં પતે છે ત્યાંથી મારી સ્ટોરીની શરૂઆત છે. એ છેલ્લો ભાગ જે ક્લાઇમેક્સ છે ત્યાંથી મારી સ્ટોરી શરૂ થાય છે. 15 લોંગ આવર્સ with the hijackers in that small aircraft. They were long. They were like 15 long years. But suddenly there was a paradoxical change. Suddenly after 15 hours, the pace at which things moved, they were too fast. They were not even in minutes or seconds. They were like fractions. So what comes to me are flashes. So I'm going to share flashes with you. During these 15 hours, what we saw was the four hijackers, their shift from ruthlessness to frustration to anger. Definitely, their needs were not met, their demands were not met. And that particular thing is very, very brilliantly captured by Ram Madhavan in his film. Here are flashes which are stored in the memories. First one. Suddenly the air conditioner turns off. The next, the lights gets dimmer, and all of a sudden it's pitch dark. We were four girls sitting together. I could not even see the girl sitting next to me. The next, we hear a loud prayer sound. One of the main hijackers saying a prayer sounded like Arabic to me. The next flash, gun firing and blasts of the hand grenades. The next, I felt a hot ball coming from my foot in my body, hot ball of fire entering my body. Next flash, someone falling on my shoulder, my friend falling on my shoulder. Next, there were deafening screams of people all around me, everyone trying to get up and run. Next, somehow we decided, it was me, Urmi, and Rupal, and one more girl. So me and Urmi, we decided somehow that we have to hold Rupal because she was hardly able to hold herself. We also got up and in this chaos tried to come out of the aircraft. While we were coming out, pushed in this mad rush, we stepped down something, and what I saw was an unimaginable sight. I was on the wing of this Boeing aircraft, which was about 21 feet, about second to third floor of a high-story building. As soon as we came out, the first gush of fresh air after 15 hours touched us, and I felt something warm dripping down my feet. હું નીચે જોવા ગઈ કે આ શું છે અને હું મારા પગ જોઈ શકું એ પહેલાં મેં રૂપલના પગ જોયા જેને અમે પકડેલી હતી એન્ડ ઇટ વોઝ ડ્રેન્ચ્ડ વિથ બ્લડ આઈ ડેર્ડ નોટ સી માય મેં જોયું જ નહીં આઈ ડિસાઇડેડ વી કેનોટ જમ્પ સો વી કેમ બેક ઇન ધી એરક્રાફ્ટ વન્સ અગેન ઓલ થ્રી ઓફ અસ હોલ્ડિંગ ઈચ અધર ટુ ગો ટુ ઓલ ધ વે ડાઉન to the chute to slide down. While we came inside, we were against the crowd because everyone was trying to come out. So in that mad rush of pull and push, somewhere I lost my friends. So by the time I reached the chute and I was sitting on the chute, too scared to look down, I closed my eyes. I was alone. The air hostess pushed me. Within a fraction of a second, I was down. And that was it. That thud, the pressure with which I fell down, hobij na thai shaki. Karan ke tyan sudhi to kai khabar j nahoti ke shu thayu chhe. Pan kai khatu ke jethi hu ubhi na thai shaki. There was another thud. Biji ek chokri mari pachal padi. She got up immediately. I held her hand. Maine kidu, please help me. I can't get up. She helped me. Maan hu ubhi thai. And leaning on her, my weight on her body, khoob dheere dheere, we were walking on the tarmac towards the airport. There were people around us. All of them were running in panic. Suddenly, people started screaming. They are coming. They are following. So it might have so happened that all these four hijackers, they were out of their ammunitions. And they were also trying to run with us, camouflaging with us. But the petrified crowd was too scared to even look at them, to have the sight of them. So everyone started running fast. Suddenly my stranger friend, she looked at me. We exchanged a sympathetic glance. I still remember that face. I still have that face in my memory. I have no idea about her name. She was almost my age, short hair. She just gave me that glance and she left my hand and she ran away. I was standing there. There were these four hijackers. People were screaming and running. They were following. And I could spot a line of Pakistani commandos in front of us. Between the airport and the tarmac, wearing the Pathani dress. I was scared I was shit scared of that sight also. What to do? I could not even stand. Forget about walking. And between all these chaos, so much of noise around me, there was a faint sound coming from inside of me which was trying to capture my attention. That sound started growing louder and louder. It was telling me, Janki, you have to do this alone, and you can do it. It started growing louder and louder to that extent that all this noise around me silenced out. And only I could hear this inner voice from inside guiding me to put one step further forward. I followed it. I put one step and the other and the other, and I was running. I was running within no time. And while I was approaching the line of these commandos, I was in a state of nothingness. I crossed that also. And very soon, in the airport, on the lounge, I saw familiar faces, all silenced due to panic. But I sat there. And the next I walked was after 3 months. This is my first story. Going to the second story, after this, I was taken to the Jinnah Hospital, which is the public hospital like our civil hospital in Karachi. I was in the casualty ward. It was absolutely mad, traumatic. I tried to go into my deafening deep within to avoid the screams around me. I could recognize my friend Rupal screaming. The bombs which had affected us had perhaps fallen on her lap, and she was not saved after that incident. So I was made to lie down on one bench there. So many people passing by gave me so many pricks here and there, not asking what, why, for what they are giving. Very soon, I was moved to a hospital room, a ward. It was a big room with tall ceilings, very dim light. And I could not see anyone else except me. And suddenly I see these two young men enter the room straight to my bed. I was immobile. By that time, my pain had increased so much. I could barely breathe. I was so scared. These two men, they came near me, sat down near the bed, introduced themselves. Salaam alaikum, main Dr. Farhat, ye Dr. Mehboob. Hum yahan pe resident doctors hain. Aap fikar mat kare. Hum aapke liye yahan hai, hazir hai, kuch kaam hai, to farmaiye. Very, in a way, not just like my salwar was drenched in blood and my leg was swelling up. So not just they treated my physical wound, gave me some painkillers, but very casually, very warmly, and very in a friendly manner, they started talking to me. All about Delhi, about India, about the films, about my friends, my family, about his friends, about the books I read. And we started, at that time, I was seeing some Pakistani serial. Some Zoya Ali Khan was my favorite Pakistani actress. I talked about him and he immediately connected. So they made me feel so comfortable. That day, in that dark night, between three of us, what happened? Dr. Farhat was a Sunni Muslim, Dr. Mehboob a Shia Muslim, myself a Hindu girl of 19. What happened that night was the epitome of humanity. It was something so beautiful that if at all we need anything called religion in our civilization, it should be just one, and that is humanity. In some time, towards the early dawn, he disappeared. One of them, Farhat, disappeared. Mehboob was still there looking after me. He soon came back with a cup of coffee. By that time, he had realized that I like coffee. A toothbrush. So thoughtful. A toothbrush, a toothpaste, and because my dress was all drenched in blood, he borrowed some friend's dress, a green salwar kameez with matching bangles and a green bindi, because he thought that Hindu girl hai, ladki hai, to bindi zaruri hai. He gave me that. The next day, during the morning, we were finally, all the PanAm passengers were shifted to one ward, so we were with people, other passengers. A lot of people were coming to meet us, NGOs and a lot of women organizations and leaders were coming, very nicely connecting with us, offering us sweets, etc. My parents then, late Hariprasad Bhai and Kokila Ben Vyas, they were very much into communal harmony in India. So through a common friend, Shiraz Bastawala uncle, they got in touch with Babu Bhai Maulin in Karachi. So uncle came to meet me. He was hunting from pillar to post to find this Janki Vyas. Finally he came there and he was so happy to see me. And he offered, jaise hi wo aaye, aap Janki Vyas hain? Maine kaha haan. Inshallah, aisa kehke mere sir pe haath rakha, tum theek ho, tumhare papa aur mummy kitna fikar kar rahe hain, ab main unko bata dunga. While he was leaving, he gave me a 10-rupee note saying that hamare mein betiyon ko milte hain to shugun karte hain. Nothing is different between the two countries. It's just all the same. And he left. Perhaps he must have gone back and informed my family where I am. So sometimes during that afternoon, a hospital boy came looking. Ke ye yahan hai, aapke ghar se phone aaya hai. I was immobile in the bed. Us time cordless to the hi nahi. And I wanted to fly and pick that phone up. You know, I missed a heartbeat hearing ke mere ghar se phone hai. Par main kya karti? So then wo banda bola, koi baat nahi behan, hum bata dete hain, aap idhar hai, thik thak hai, hum phone pe baat kar lete hain. And I was like, tears falling through my eyes. I was so desperate and yet helpless. I said, theek hai. And these two boys, Dr. Farhat and Mehboob, they read my eyes. And they said, nahi, 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 hum jayenge. Pura khatiya utha liya. They pura mera bed utha liya. And when two of them started to do it, other two helped. They took me to the telephone booth outside. I spoke with my family. And that moment, you can imagine, back then the media was almost very, very, very less. So they had no idea that moment when they heard my voice after almost 36 hours of suspense. There was a relief in their hearts that Janki is alive. So this very precious moment, these sensitive doctors of Karachi, they gifted to us, our family. So, I don't know what to say. I could say a lot, but I think I have said. This is my second story. Now to talk about the third thing. Once again, there are these three things which I want to share, which is what I took beyond the two stories, the real stories that happened in my journey of life. One is these amazing people of Pakistan, the so-called Muslims, the things which we have heard about them since we have grown up, and the warmth, their love, their humanity, not just the two doctors, the entire next day, what happened in the hospital has made me deeply, deeply secular. I learned the true meaning of the word secular. Second, when I talked about my inner voice, that particular moment when I transcended out of my body and I'm seeing myself walking and running, that has, I think, given me a lot of connect with my inner self. My inner strength is thanks to perhaps that one moment, and my spiritual bent to everything that I do, I read, or I do in life. I think that was one thing which took me there. Because so many incidences happens in our life, but what we do with that, how we respond to that, how we process that, makes that incidence an experience. And such experiences, they somewhere make a pivotal change inside of us, which changes the direction in which you take your life. And the third and the most important thing is, at that time, when I needed someone, some love, some warmth, the most, and I was at a place where I expected it the least, and I got it. I realized the value of receiving. I was a receiver's end that time. Even when I came back from there, my family, my friends, my family's family friends, the amount of sympathy and love and warmth I have received, I have learned the biggest thing is value of giving. And that is why perhaps deep down inside me, I am a giver. Because I have received at that time when I needed the most, and I know what it means when to give someone who needs it. And perhaps that's the reason why I founded Samvedna, and I am with my children and my women, and I can understand them. I can understand the needs of the society, and it's a beautiful journey.
Thank you very much for sharing this, Jankibin. What you did tell us once earlier also was that after that day and that night, you have developed a lasting friendship with those two doctors from Pakistan.
Yes, we are still in touch. We are still in touch. Babu Bhai, the uncle I mentioned, he came for our wedding also. And Farhad calls. You know the times when he calls? He calls on 15th August. Because unki agle din hoti hai Independence Day. 15th ko mujhe Happy Independence Day wish karte. And inevitably, India-Pakistan ka jab match hota hai, tab my phone rings after the match ends. Mostly India wins. Congratulations, aap fir se jeet gayi. Maine kaha, haan.
So that's a very lovely, heartwarming story. And that was the reason why we felt as a literature festival that we should bring it to a larger audience for you all to know that there is so much more friendship can do rather than hatred and enmity. With that, on that note, I move on to the next story. Khanjan, over to you.
Gandhiji ni parivaad chikin, eye for an eye will make the world go blind. Well, I think it's already blind because we beat Ahmedabad or Aleppo, it's the same thing, you know, wherever you go. So, for me, it is very important to share, like she shared two episodes. I would also like to share two episodes. One is probably the very, very similar to her experience, is that I would like to say, start with, જ્યારે લાઇટ એકદમ ડીમ થઈ ગઈ હતી ને વેર વી કુડન્ટ સી હુઝ હુ કપલ ઓફ અસ વેર મેડ ટુ સિટ ઇન ધી આઇલ ઓફ ધી એરક્રાફ્ટ જમીન ઉપર નીચે લાઇનમાં બેસાડી દીધા હતા આગળ બોલાવીને હવે માય મધર વોઝ સિટિંગ બિહાઇન્ડ મી અને એણે મને મારા એના ખોળામાં બેસાડ્યો હતો મારા આગળ મારા માસી બેઠા હતા અને બીજા આગળ એવી રીતે થોડાક લોકોને બેસાડ્યા એમાં જ્યારે લાઇટ ડિમ થઈ ને જે વાત છે કે જે ફાયરિંગ પછી સ્ટાર્ટ થયું ને દેન ઇટ વોઝ અ ટોટલ કેઓસ I have a memory which is completely blank at a certain point because I did, at one point of time, my mother ene maru mathu ena khola ma naki didu ane the next moment I did feel something falling onto my back. So without even realizing what was that, મારા માસી આગળ બેઠા હતા એમણે મારી પાછળ તરફ જોઈને કીધું કે તારું માથું તું સીટ બંને બાજુ સીટ્સ હતી એ સીટની અંદરની બાજુ નાખી દે જેથી કરીને તને ગોળી ના વાગે સો એમાં માથું મેં સીટની અંદરની બાજુ નાખી દીધું. પ્રોબ્લી દેટ ઇઝ દેટ્સ હાઉ આઈ હેવ સર્વાઈવડ. એન્ડ આફ્ટર દેટ વેન એવરીબડી સ્ટાર્ટેડ રનિંગ ટુવર્ડ્સ ધી ડોર્સ વિચ આર ઓપન બાય પીપલ સિટિંગ નેક્સ્ટ ટુ ધ ડોર ઓર આઈ થિંક નયનભાઈને ખબર છે કોણે ખોલ્યો દરવાજો. ઘણા બધા લોકોએ એ દરવાજો ખોલ્યો હતો. I ran towards a door and I got off to a wing which was again very very high. તો એમાંથી કૂદીને નીચે જવું એક બહુ મોટો વિચાર આવતો છે, કારણ કે ખાસું ઊંચું હોય છે, લગભગ 20 ફૂટ જેટલું ઊંચું હોય છે. આઈ વોઝ જસ્ટ અબાઉટ ટુ જમ્પ એન્ડ સમબડી કોટ મી ફ્રોમ બિહાઇન્ડ સેડ કે ડોન્ટ જમ્પ, યુ નો યુ વિલ હર્ટ યોર સેલ્ફ, ડોન્ટ જમ્પ. પાછળથી ખેંચી અને બેને કીધું કે પાછું પ્લેનમાં જઈને જે બાજુથી જે સ્લાઇડ છે ત્યાંથી નીચે જા. નાઉ ધીસ ઇઝ વન ઓફ ધ મોસ્ટ સ્કેરીએસ્ટ પાર્ટ ટુ એકચ્યુઅલી વેન યુ વેન શી સેડ દેટ યુ નો યુ બ્રીથ ધ ફ્રેશ એર એન્ડ યુ આર આઉટ એન્ડ દેન સમબડી સેઇંગ દેટ યુ હેવ ટુ ગો બેક ઇનસાઇડ એન્ડ દેન ટેક ધીસ. એનો જે એની જે બીક હોય છે એ બહુ ભયાનક હોય છે. આઈ ડોન્ટ નો કેવી રીતે હિંમત ભેગી કરીને કોઈકે મને પાછળથી ઉપર ચડાવીને પ્લેનમાં પાછો મૂક્યો, દોડી સ્લાઇડથી નીચે ગયો. રસ્તામાં મને અમારી જોડે મેહુલભાઈ હતા એ મળ્યા. એમણે મને પૂછ્યું કે મમ્મી ક્યાં છે. મારો જવાબ એ જ હતો કે મને નથી ખબર. હવે એ જવાબ મેં એવું કેમ આપ્યો મને નથી ખબર આજ સુધી. પ્રોબ્લી માય સબકોન્શિયસ ઇઝ સ્ટીલ બ્લોકિંગ અ વેરી વેરી ગ્રુસમ મેમરી ઓફ ઇટ અને આજ સુધી મને એનો જવાબ નથી મળ્યો. હું ઘણી વાર શોધવાનો પ્રયત્ન કરું છું કે શું શું હતું એ, મેં આવો જવાબ કેમ આપ્યો અને આટલી સ્વસ્થતાથી કેમ આપ્યો હતો જવાબે. આઈ વોઝન્ટ હર્ટ એટ ઓલ. એઝ વી સેડ દેટ વી વે ઓલ ટ્રાન્સફર ટુ અ હોટેલ વેર યુ નો વી સ્ટેડ દેર એટ નાઇટ એન્ડ મારા કપડા વેર ઓલ્સો ડ્રેન્સ્ડ ઇન અધર્સ બ્લડ, નોટ માઇન બટ કમ્પ્લીટલી આઈ ડોન્ટ નો માય મધર્સ બ્લડ ઓર સમબડી એલ્સિસ બ્લડ ઇઝ કમ્પ્લીટલી ડ્રેન્સ્ડ વિથ ધેટ. સો સમબડી હુમ ન્યૂ દેટ દેર આર પીપલ સ્ટેઇંગ હિયર હેડ કમ એન્ડ ગિવન ક્લોથ્સ એન્ડ ચપ્પલ્સ એન્ડ થિંગ્સ લાઇક દેટ. સો આઈ ફાઉન્ડ સમ ક્લોથ્સ ફ્રોમ દેટ. માય આન્ટ એન્ડ એવરીબડી વેન્ટ એન્ડ ગોટ ધીઝ ક્લોથ્સ એન્ડ સો દેટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો વન ઓફ ધ થિંગ્સ દેટ યુ નો. એવું કંઈ જરૂરી નથી કે ઓળખતા જ હોય એટલે આપી ગયા છે કે એનો માણસ છે, માણસ મુશ્કેલીમાં છે, હશે કશું એમ કરીને વસ્તુઓ બી લોકો આપી ગયેલા છે. એટલે એ બહુ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ વાત છે, માણસાઈની વાત બહુ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ હોય છે. હવે ધીસ ઇઝ ધ ફર્સ્ટ સ્ટોરી. સેકન્ડ સ્ટોરી ઇઝ ફ્યુ યર્સ બેક મને એવો વિચાર આવ્યો હતો કે યુનો કોઈક માણસને જ્યારે એમ થાય કે ના હું મારી નાખું કોઈને, કે આવું કંઈક હાઈજેક કરું, કે તો શે શું શું કારણ હશે એ માણસનું. વોટ ઇઝ ધ રીઝન બિહાઇન્ડ સમબડી બિકમિંગ, આઈ મીન વી ડોન્ટ વી ઓલવેઝ આર લુકિંગ એટ ધીસ હોલ સ્ટેમ્પ સેઇંગ સમબડી ઇઝ અ ટેરરિસ્ટ. હેવ વી એવર ઇન્ક્વાયર્ડ ઇન ટુ ઇફ સચ એન્ડ સચ પર્સન ઓર સચ એન્ડ સચ ઇઝ અ ટેરરિસ્ટ, વોટ વર ધ સર્કમ. માણસ સર્કમસ્ટન્સીસમાં ખરાબ બનતો હોય છે, જન્મજાત ખરાબ નથી હોતો. સો આઈ સ્ટાર્ટેડ ઇન્ક્વાયરિંગ ઇન ટુ ધીસ હોલ એપિસોડ દેટ એમાં એક માણસ ધ મેઇન ધ લીડર ઇઝ સ્ટીલ અલાઈવ એન્ડ દે વર જેલ્ડ ઇન પાકિસ્તાન ફોર 15 યર્સ એન્ડ દેન ઇન 2000 ફોર સમ રીઝન દે વર રિલીઝડ એન્ડ દે વર again trying to escape, and the leader was caught in Bangkok by CIA and was taken to America, and he has been trialed for that. And 2001 માં જ્યારે અમારી પાસે વાત આવી ત્યારે બધાએ સ્ટેટમેન્ટ આપ્યા હતા કે વેન હી વોઝ કોટ એન્ડ ધ વેન હી વોઝ બીંગ ટ્રાઈડ ઇન ધ ફેડરલ કોર્ટ ઇન અમેરિકા બધાએ સ્ટેટમેન્ટ્સ આપવાના હતા કે યુ નો શું દરેકની વાત છે કે જે વિચ વુડ ઇવેન્ચ્યુઅલી મેક હિમ ગિલ્ટી ઓફ સર્ટન ક્રાઇમ એન્ડ ધેન વીલ પુટ હિમ ઇન jail for whatever. So he's right now he has a sentence of 160 years, which probably he's probably not going to get out of jail for his life. So I said, why not let me speak to this person. And he jode hu ek var patra vyavhar to kari jo ki bhai tu te tu e kai shu karyu che jeni tu ek to pehla tu jawabdari le che biju tu jawabdari lai rahyo hoy તો તું તે શા માટે આ વસ્તુ કરી મારે જાણવું છે મારે એ જાણવું છે કે તારામાં એવું શું છે તને એટલો શું ગુસ્સો છે કે તે આ વસ્તુ કરેલી અથવા તારું પોલિટિકલ મોટિવેશન એટલું બધું શું છે કે તું જેને કોઈ લેવા દેવા નથી એને મારવા માટે તૈયાર થઈ ગયો સો આઈ રોટ ટુ હિમ સેટ યુ નો યુ 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 શેર સમ સ્ટોરી ઓફ યુઅર્સ સો એનો પહેલો જ મેઇલ જ્યારે એનો જવાબ આવ્યો ત્યારે એણે મને કીધું કે મિસ્ટર દલાલ આઈ એમ ટ્રુલી ડીપલી સોરી ફોર માય વોટ એવર આઈ હેવ ડન ઇન માય અર્લિયર લાઈફ વિચ હેઝ કોઝ્ડ પેન ટુ સો મેની પીપલ એન્ડ સો મેની પીપલ હેવ લોસ્ટ દેર લાઈફ્સ એન્ડ આઈ હેવ નો વર્ડ્સ how I would like to apologize to them. So if you want to believe me, I am deeply, deeply sorry for that. There is no, what do you say? And then, evi, aa vastu ne manvi ke na manvi e apna par chhe. It's up to us, whether we want to believe this or not. I'm still in on that question. Secondly, I said, you share your story. So he told me a very interesting story. He said, Mr. Dalal, when I was 8 years old, I grew up in Kuwait because as a Palestinian family, my whole family was thrown out of our homes when in the 48 there was a war where the Israelis drew out a lot of Palestinians from their homeland. And so our motto was to fight for our homeland. And when I was 8 years old, when I was going to school, we were like 400 children in Kuwait, all refugees. And we had a particular maths teacher who used to, before starting the session, he would say, let's sing all the songs of freedom. And let's sing all the songs whom we want to kill. Now, see how તમે 9 વર્ષના બાળકોને કઈ ટાઈપના ગીતો ગવડાવો છો બીજું અને આખી પ્રજામાં પણ કેટલો રોષ છે કે એ વસ્તુ કરે છે પછી એને એક વખત એક કોઈક મેથ્સનો દાખલો હતો એમાં એક ભાઈ 9માંથી 4 જાય તો કેટલા રહે એને જવાબ નહોતો ખબર ડરતો એને કીધું એક મિનિટ એક કામ કરીએ હું તને શીખવાડું કેવી રીતે કરવાનું તારી સામે 9 જૂઝ ઊભા છે એમાંથી તું 4ને મારી નાખીશ તો કેટલા વધશે This is the point. This is your So be aware of who your teacher is. Be aware of what sort of surrounding that you are brought up. So probably it is so true for the entire world today also. Those who are terrorists, those who are foot soldiers, say that militants or whatever, emne kevi rite brainwash karvama aave chhe. Now this man is still alive to tell his story. And I'm glad that he's writing a book about that. And I do want the world to read that story too. જે માણસ કશુંક આવું કરવા તૈયાર થાય છે એની પણ એક એક જિંદગી છે, એક સ્ટોરી હોય છે, એ પણ એક માણસ છે. અને એ માણસાઈની દ્રષ્ટિએ હું સાંભળવા તૈયાર છું. જાણવું છે મારે. આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ નો. ધેટ્સ ઇટ. થેન્ક યુ.
થેન્ક્સ કંજન. એક્સ્ટ્રીમલી મૂવિંગ. ધેર આર couple of things that I don't know if it's clear that he mentioned or not. His mom Truptiben passed away in that hijack. There were 21 people on board that flight from Ahmedabad. Two of them passed away. Rupal is Janki Ben's friend that she spoke about, and Khanjan's mother Truptiben passed away as well. It's not clear, but it's not beyond imagination that the guy he's been communicating with is perhaps the guy who hit her the bullet.
Yeah, so might have been the bullet might have been from his gun, but I'm still willing to give him a chance. That way.
And that, again, I repeat, is the reason why we thought this story must be told. It should be spoken about again and again, that it's people who get hurt who are really affected by this and who are willing to go beyond the obvious and to say that things are not unidimensional. There are many, many more dimensions to it. Janki Ben, Khanjan, and many more, about 19 other people in the city, all of them are talking about it, still thinking about it, it's a part of their life, and all of them are here and in Ahmedabad to talk about it. At this point, is there anything else that either of you would like to add? Janki Ben, would you like to add something?
It was a very sad incident. It was a terrorist attack. We lost two lives. We went 21, came back 19. But one important lesson which I learned from this is that when you come so close to death, or when you come so close to seeing your own people die right there in front of you, like Trupti Ben was our teacher, dance teacher, and she was a favorite to everyone. She was such a warm, and she was a mother to everyone. But still, one thing which I learned out of it is to value life. Because when you know death, you value life. And what's important in life? One is relationships, and most important is compassion with which you come out. And secondly, today is the day. Live it. You don't know what is the next moment going to bring to you. So live your today. And we are very, very happy that we had such a wonderful person like Trupti Ben in our lives, and Rupal close to me. And we were together that whole day. So she was constantly talking. We were not behaving like the hijackers came, the terrorists came twice to us with a gunpoint. Because the three girls were giggling all the time. Because she was just engaged 3 days back. So she was sharing about her. I had, my husband now was my friend then. I was talking about him. I was writing a letter. I love to write. So, you know, we shared such precious moments together that last day. So make the most of your life, because you never know what's the second moment has to offer. Right, Khanjan? Yeah?
I still can't get over the phobia of an aircraft today. Mare plane ma jo besvanu hoy to mare dawa leine besvu pade chhe. Etle all these things are all there. You know, what is trauma? How you deal with your trauma? So, like she said, that all these things, every one of us will have some sort of a trauma, and how you deal with it, and then how you live is very important.
they do deserve a round of applause for coming up on the stage here, for recalling the entire journey, their memories, and not to say the least, it must have been painful for them then. It is painful for them now. I can see it on their faces, and we really appreciate it. Once again, thank you very much, Janki Ben Kanjan, for coming here. And now we open the floor for questions. Anybody from the audience would like to ask them anything, you're welcome to do that. Excellent. Is there? If no, then.
Janki Ben Khanjan Bhai, bahu dukhdayak pan sari vato share kari. Enu હું પોતે વિનીત મોદી અમદાવાદમાં છું, વર્કિંગ જર્નાલિસ્ટ છું. મારું પોતાનું પર્સનલ શેરિંગ એવું છે કે આજે ઘણી બધી નેશનલ અને ઇન્ટરનેશનલ એરલાઇનની ઓફિસો અમદાવાદમાં છે, પણ એ સમયે પાનમ એરલાઇન ઇન્ટરનેશનલ એરલાઇન હતી, અમદાવાદથી ઓપરેટ નહોતી થતી, પણ એની બુકિંગ ઓફિસ અમદાવાદમાં હતી, લોહા ભવન, જે ગુજરાત હાઈકોર્ટ જૂનીની પાછળ એની ઓફિસ હતી. અને હું એવું માનું છું કે તમારા બધાની 21 ટિકિટો એ જગ્યાએથી જ બુક થઈ હતી. મારું પર્સનલ મેમોરી એવું છે કે એ બુકિંગ ઓફિસમાં મારાથી મોટા, 10 વર્ષ મોટા મારા પિતરાઈભાઈ, કઝિન બ્રધર, એમાં એ બુકિંગનું કામ સંભાળતા, અને એમણે જ તમારી ટિકિટો બુક કરી હતી. આજે તો એવો અમેરિકામાં વસે છે, પણ આ ઘટનાનું એમણે પણ એટલું દુઃખ એટલું છે કે નિર્જા ફિલ્મ રિલીઝ થયા પછી અમેરિકામાં DVD પર જોઈ ને મને તરત આખી ઘટના માટે રિકોલ કર્યો હતો. તો આ મારી પર્સનલ મેમોરી છે. થેન્ક યુ.
ધીસ ક્વેશ્ચન ધેર, આઈ થિંક ડુ વી હેવ ટાઈમ આરતી ફોર વન મોર ક્વેશ્ચન.
હેલો, યે આઈ એમ ટોલ્ડ ધેટ ધેર આર સો મેની અધર પીપલ ઓફ ધેટ રિમેનિંગ 22 આર હિયર. કેન વી જસ્ટ સી ધેમ સો ધેટ વી હેવ અ રાઉન્ડ ઓફ અપ્લોઝ ફોર ધેમ? Because each one would have their own story.
Yes, please, those who are Nayan Bhai, Preeti Ben, Palamashi, Mehul Bhai, all, please get up. They all have their own stories, which are lovely.
Mehul, Preeti, and અમારા પલામાસી, આમ તો જાનકીબેને જે સ્ટોરી યાદ કરી અમને, અમે લોકો પણ થોડા ડિસ્ટર્બ થયા. ખંજન અને એ લોકોને અમે લોકો જે યાતનામાંથી બહાર આવ્યા એ વાત કરી બેને. વિશેષ તો કંઈ નથી કહેવાનું, પણ અમે અમારા ગ્રુપના જ બે વ્યક્તિને ગુમાવ્યા, એનું પણ બહુ ભારોભાર દુઃખ રહ્યું. અને ખંજને કીધું એ પ્રમાણે હું પણ આજની તારીખમાં જ્યારે કોઈપણ એરલાઇનમાં કેરિયરમાં બેસું છું તો બહુ ડર લાગે છે. એક વસ્તુ મને ખબર પડી એ વખતે કે એક માણસ બીજા માણસને જો આ રીતે પણ આ કક્ષાએ જઈ શકે, અને છતાં જ્યારે જાનકીબેને જે વાત કરી તો પાકિસ્તાનમાં જ્યારે મને જિન્ના હોસ્પિટલમાં આઈ વોર્ડમાં રાખ્યો હતો, મને ઇમરજન્સી એક્ઝિટ ખોલતા એ લોકોએ ગ્રેનેડ ફેંક્યો એટલે મારી આંખ આખી બહાર આવી ગઈ અને મને આઈ વોર્ડમાં લઈ ગયા. મને બરાબર યાદ છે જાનકીબેન અને હું, અમે બધા પાણી પાણીની બૂમો પાડતા હતા, બરાબર જાનકીબેન, ત્યાં હોસ્પિટલ. એટલે એમ કે બહુ તરસ લાગી હતી અમને એ વખતે, કારણ કે અને છતાં પણ આ બધી યાતનામાંથી પાર થયા પછી અમને ત્યાંની હ્યુમેનિટીનો બહુ જ સારો પરિચય થયો. મારા માટે થઈને એક મુસ્લિમ લેડી, એ પોતે એક નમાજ પઢતા હતા, કારણ કે એ દિવસે શુક્રવારનો દિવસ હતો, અને એ મેં મારી આંખે એક આંખે જોયું. તો બસ આ એક સ્ટોરી છે.
Was somebody else who had a question there? If not, we could maybe, yeah.
આવી કોઈક દુર્ઘટના બને ત્યારે માણસ કાં તો એકદમ આસ્તિક બની જાય છે અથવા કાં તો નાસ્તિક બની જાય છે. તો આપની સાથે શું થયું?
ના હું નાસ્તિક છું, ના હું આસ્તિક છું. આઈ ડોન્ટ હેવ એની સોર્ટ ઓફ દેટ સોર્ટ ઓફ થિંગ ઇન મી. ઇટ્સ નોટ રિક્વાયર્ડ. માણસ માણસ હોવું એ ઇનફ છે. માણસ થવાનો પ્રયત્ન કરવો ઇનફ છે.
આઈ થિંક ધીસ ઇન્સિડન્ટ ફિલ્ડ મી અ લોટ મોર વિથ લવ એન્ડ કમ્પેશન, એન્ડ ઓલ્સો આઈ ફાઉન્ડ માય ઇનર સ્ટ્રેન્થ. સો નાવ વેન એવર આઈ હેવ અ પ્રોબ્લમ, આઈ નો વેર ટુ ગો. ઇટ્સ વિદિન મી. ધી આન્સર્સ, ધ સોલ્યુશન્સ આર વિદિન મી. સો ઇટ હેઝ મેડ મી સ્ટ્રોંગર.
Khanjan, I have a question. In fact, for both of you, one of you, if you can take it first. How and when do you move on? Does the word forgiveness sort of come into it?
Yes, sure. It's very important to forgive, because nahi to apne એટલું જ રોષ આપણા મનમાં લઈને જીવીશું જે આપણા પોતાના અને આપણા કુટુંબીજનો માટે અને દુનિયા માટે હાનિકારક છે. સો એ બહુ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ છે. ફરગિવિંગ ઇઝ વેરી 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 ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ. એન્ડ માય હોલ જર્ની રાઇટ નાવ ઇઝ અબાઉટ ધેટ. ધ રીઝન વાય આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ નો અબાઉટ ધીઝ પીપલ ઓલ્સો ઇઝ સો દેટ someday I will be able to forgive and let it go from me. Thank you.
Janki, would you like to say something about
it? I think that is a very relevant question for Khanjan, and he has answered it very well. Though I want to add one thing. I see a lot of young people there, and there's one thing about me. I don't like stories with a sad end. I like happy ends. And so I want to share something around the same thing, because I work with Samvedna, I work with children in extreme poverty. There's so much of abuse, there's so much of problems in the world, but I believe that I can give only what I have. So only if I have 10 rupees, I will be able to give 9, right? So following the same principle, if I also fill myself with sadness, how will I be able to, offer them any happiness or hope? So that's from where I'm coming. And so I remember the day, March 8th, 2008. I get a phone call. And main Janki Vyas se baat kar sakta hoon? Maine kaha, haan, main bol rahi hoon. To bole, main Dr. Farhad bolta hoon Karachi se, aapne mujhe pehchana? So we had lost touch, because you know how life takes us on. We get married, contacts gets faded, mobiles come in, wrong phone numbers have changed. We were not in touch. We were busy with our own lives. So it so happened, Jumana, that some friend of Farhad had come to Ahmedabad, aur kyunki wo mujhe pehle letter likhte the, aur wo bhi bahut mazedar baat hai. First letter aaya unka. और क्योंकि मैं हिंदी बोलती थी, हिंदी बहुत सिमिलर है उर्दू से, सो उन्होंने सोचा मैं उर्दू जानती हूँ, तो मुझे उर्दू में लेटर आया, फर्स्ट वन. एंड देन आई हैड टू गो टू प्रोफेसर शमशी टू रीड दिस आउट फॉर मी. एनीवे, सो ही हैड माय ओल्ड मॉम्स एड्रेस. सो वो भी उन्होंने ये एड्रेस दे के उनके फ्रेंड को बोला कि इनको ढूँढो, इनका नंबर क्या है ढूँढो. एंड वो भी ऐसी बात थी कि mom, dad are now no more, but my brother also had shifted from that place, and the last week of shifting was happening, so he was there. So unko pucha ke ye yahan rehti thi, he gave my mobile number and he took it back to Karachi and he called me that way. And we did not know whether to laugh or cry. I was filled with nostalgia, and he had to share about his family, his wife, his children. I talked about my family. And, you know, a new relationship, a new bond developed. He called me for his daughter's wedding, but unfortunately I could not go then. So life is a beautiful journey. You don't know which dots are created, why, when. It's all about connecting them in an upward graph and find your own happiness out of it.
Yes, so on that note, we'll end this relatively melancholic session amidst a whole range of humor and laughter sessions. And we'll go back to some fun. Naishad and his team will do a vachikam here and say about, Naishad, 5 minutes? Yep, I think we should be on in 5 minutes. And thank you very much for patiently listening to us, for being a lovely audience. Have a good night.
Thank you so much, Jumana.